we're here to look at the basic setup of the sustainable housing equipment. And our basic unit for our sustainable house is this nifty cube. The cube has 4 feet on the bottom. It has a spring-loaded top. We can pull that up a little bit. It has foam here to give a good seal so that when we put in panels, there won't be any losses of heat from inside from convection. The first thing we want to put in is a temperature sensor. The temperature sensor has a temperature sensor on the inside and a connector on the outside. So to put it in, it's a matter of pushing the panel in at the bottom and then pulling up with the fingers and putting it in there and letting the top drop down again. So you can see the sensor is at the bottom and where you connect it up to the data logger is at the top. I'll just connect that up now. It goes there. I'll put that into temperature sensor spot number 1 on the data logger. Next, we want to build up our house that we're going to do measurements on. We can put these two together so we can have a two-story house, or we can have them side by side for terracing. We can also put on a roof panel and we can put in different types of roofing materials at the top to see what effect they have on the temperature inside the house. Because we only want to change one variable at a time, if I'm looking at, say, the effects of double glazing, I don't want to have anything else being changed in it. So I recommend you use these white insulated panels. They are 10 centimetres by 10 centimetres. We have floor tiles in our teacher kit, which come as a 10 centimetre by 10 centimetre ready-made. So I'll put those in the sides. I'll put one at the bottom and I can put another one in at the top later on. For double glazing, there are 4 panels in the student kit, and if you look up close, the panels have a ridge around them. So if I put them ridge to ridge, put them into the bottom, lift up the top, push them into place. Ridge to ridge means there's a gap of air caught in between them. If I wanted to test the effect of the same thickness of perspex, I would put flat face to flat face and push those into position there, then put on the top and we're ready to run our experiment. To simulate the sun, we use the power supply and a lamp. This one is a 50 watt lamp. Turn that on and we can just have the sun shining directly onto it. Then go through and log the temperature for as long as you want and test the effects. I recommend about 5 minutes of collecting data is enough to get good graphs.